For Crema Media's Polity, I'm Sane Dlamini. Joining me today is the KZN Provincial Chairperson for the Economic Freedom Fighters, Vusi Khoza, to discuss the party manifesto. So, Mr. Khoza, your party's emphasis is on expropriation of South Africa's land without compensation for equal redistribution in use. How do you plan to address this issue?
Thank you very much. Yes, our commitment is derived from our seven cardinal pillars upon which the EFF is established. Our pillar number one is expropriation of land without compensation for equitable use. What we are saying is that we know for a fact that since 1652, coming back to 1913 and during apartheid, black people were systematically removed from usable, arable, profitable land. And they were sent into the hinterland when whites stayed in fertile land and made a lot of money from it. That's one. Number two, we believe as the economic freedom fighters that land is wealth. Whatever you want to do, economic infrastructure, business, you require land. Even underneath the land, that's where mineral resources are kept. So as an EFF, we are saying we want land to be equally distributed, firstly, for us to be able to use it for agriculture, to guarantee food security. Secondly, to use it for human settlement, so that we are able to build this big, spacious houses. And thirdly, to actually use it for recreation and for businesses. Because if you are to create jobs, our theme or slogan for the local government election, theme of our manifesto is land and jobs manage. So you need land for you to be able to create jobs through massive industrialization. That's what we were talking about as the EFF when we talk about expropriating land. Because even for you to put an infrastructure, you require land.
And your party also promises that every municipality will procure its food from emerging farmers. But the question is, what about the commercial farmers, Mr. Khoza?
Commercial farmers have been making money all along, and they are not sharing that money with any of us. Instead, they are taking it to offshore accounts and creating wealth in other countries. There will be enough. We've got enough people in South Africa, and commercial farmers can actually export their food or produce for export. All we are saying is that if you come to our municipality for argument's sake, you want to assemble cars, and you build a factory that assembles cars, we must make sure that the seats and the seat covers are locally produced. We must make sure that whatever parts that are required and can actually be manufactured locally, we do that. Let me make an example. If you come to our municipality, you want to build a mall, and you are this huge retail that deals with groceries, you must buy spinach and cabbage and eggs from local people. I mean, why must you import eggs from commercial farmers instead of helping umama, umazungu, nomamchali, nomtana wakazondi for them to breed egg chickens that produces egg? You package them and you sell it in your local market. Why must we have supermarkets that procure 100% of their food from outside our communities and from commercial farmers, when you can actually assist subsistence farmers and small scale farmers to supply the bigger chain stores?
You've just emphasized that most of the things go back to the importance of land. So I also read that you will address the issue of land burial sites, which has become a huge problem in our country. How is the EFF planning to address this issue?
You will notice that the problem, or rather biggest problem, is lack of land. Immediately when you drive out of these urban areas, you see streams and streams and I mean large pieces of land that is lying without use. And yet people must pay for a burial site. You can't tax a person when they are alive and even tax them when they are dead. Why must our people pay for a burial home? My grandfather is buried here. You come back 10 years later, Ukhoza is buried where your grandfather is. Where is the dignity? Where is the respect for the dead? EFF will expropriate land and provide free burial spaces for our people so that you bury your loved ones with dignity without paying a cent. Because when they were alive, they contributed to the economy of the city, the economy of the country. Why must they pay for death?
And your party also promises that households which depend on social grants will also qualify for free basic services. And you will also continue to fight for the increase of social grants, Mr. Khoza. Where will all this money come from?
Where is all this money that they are stealing coming from? Comes from you, the taxpayer. The only problem is that money is misappropriated, it is stolen, it is used for wrong reasons. Let's have the same database. Why must, when you go to apply for NSFAS, you must prove that your parents are unemployed, when actually your parents have got a SASA card, which means that they are receiving a SASA grant. Why must the government give on with the right hand and receive with the left hand? Because here's Oko and Muku. They are receiving a grant. And here is a single mother who depends on the grant for the children. Instead of feeding the children, then they must go and buy electricity and pay for water. The minute people are on a SASA grant, they should get free water and electricity because it means they are poverty stricken. That money that they receive must be money that they use for food. Where is this money coming from? There is money in South Africa, my sister. You must never listen to the lie that there is no money. There is money in South Africa. It's just that it is mismanaged, it is stolen, it is given to tender premiers because tender premiers give kickbacks to politicians. So we are going to do away with tenders, take that money, employ people direct. The surplus of money is going to go to feed the poor. We are going to make sure that people who are living in affluent suburbs pay for their big houses, pay for the water they use, their swimming pool. Because if, you can imagine if you've got a swimming pool, how many people from a squatter camp can you help with that water that is filling your Olympic-sized swimming pool and you hardly swim? Then we want to boast to us that you've got the biggest swimming pool in the suburb. And we know, Uti, we grew up with you, you can't swim. You are boasting a swimming pool. Take that water, let's take it to our people and feed. Otherwise, pay more for your swimming pool water. Mm.
And talking about the mismanagement of funds in our government, how does the EFF then plan to fight corruption at the local government elections, as we are talking about the local government elections, Mr. Khoza?
Corruption is very simple. Most of the corruption, my sister, starts from tenders. Tenders is what drives corruption. Why? Because when people are broke or they want to buy the latest car, they think and they say, I just create a tender very quickly and then give it to our friend who's then going to give us a kickback. If there's a job that needs to be done for 5 million, people will issue a tender, give their friend and say, I will now, you must quote for 10 million so that you can give us the 5 million back. So one, to strike on corruption, you must finish the tenders. Employ the people that are employed by the tenderpreneur, because a work for tenderpreneur is a short-term work. The minute the tender is gone, people have lost their job. But if you employ them directly in the municipality, things are going to be cheaper. You are going to have money. Number two, there must be what we call consequence management. We need to make sure that we deal harshly with people that are suspected of corruption. Let's take a chairman, for example, to quickly demonstrate to you how corruption works. The ex-mayor of Etegwini, Zandile Gumede, and those people that, including Usiponzuza, who is who was a municipal manager at the time, they came up with a 250 million tender, claiming that it's for waste removal, Komlazi, and other surrounding areas, created bogus companies who did not deliver anything, who never picked up any rubbish, but submitted invoice. The whole 250 million, not a single piece of rubbish was picked up from the township. They used a tender system to facilitate corruption. That's how money is being mismanaged and spent. Do you know that one toilet paper that you can buy for 5 rand, when tender
premiers supply the municipality,
they charge the municipality 35 rand for one toilet paper, and that thing must never happen.
A few issues that are major issue in many municipalities, things like waste collection, potholes, water, and one of the biggest issues, the electricity outages. Does your party have a plan now to ensure that these services are effectively rolled out?
Let's start with the pothole. The current corrupt municipalities, if there's a pothole, they issue a tender to close one pothole, and that closing that one pothole will end up costing 120,000. This thing, you can close it and it will take 8 months. By the time you want to close, you budget to close that one pothole, there's 7 others. And that first pothole is about the size of a swimming pool. EFF municipalities will make sure that potholes are closed within 24 hours. By employees of the municipality, you don't need a tender. Let's come to electricity. Electricity is very simple to unroll electricity. I don't understand why at this day and age you still have people who can't have electricity in their homes. Water, for instance. We've said as EFF municipality, we are going to build the reservoirs, make sure each and every municipality, they build the reservoirs, they roll out water in infrastructure. Every household should have a water from the tap. Once you have running water, you don't need a pit toilet because you can connect water and have a flushing toilet. Even in schools, in our local schools, this nonsense that our children must use pit latrines when there is water in school. EFF is going to provide boreholes if you can't provide water. But once there is a borehole, there's no need for pit toilets. You connect water and you have a flushing toilet. Everybody deserves their dignity to be protected. They must have electricity and flushing toilets. Not this bucket system, not this pit latrines. Our children are subjected to that and traumatized. By the time they leave school, they do not value their own lives because they've been humiliated all their lives by the so-called leaders who are supposed to be providing better services for a better life so that our children will be motivated. But they are not doing that. They are bettering their families and their friends, and they're stealing the money to live a lavish lifestyle and leave our people in squalor and poverty. It is sad.
Some political parties have boasted that they have trained their councillors at a local level to be able to deal with the services and helping communities at a local government level. Is the EFF also in that space where you are training your councillors who will be representing your party to make sure that there is no mismanagement of funds?
They don't need the training. You can train a crook, you equip a crook how to steal better because it's in their nature to steal. The more you skill them, you are skilling them in stealing more. Here's what must happen. The problem with these councillors that you have at the moment, whether they're from the DA, IFP, NFP, or ANC, the minute they stay with us in the townships and the villages and the squatter camps, but the minute they get elected, they move away because now all of a sudden these voters become an irritation. They don't want to be irritated. They want to wake up at a time when they want. Baobasmos, now they've got money, bapeti in Yobu, so they don't want to be irritated by the voters. EFF has made sure that our councillors, if you are elected, you must stay in that ward where you were elected until your term is finished. That's one. Number two, you must be available on the phone 24 hours. Number three, we are going to elect you as you are because communities want you. But the minute you get in there, you become a councillor and you don't have a matric, we give you 3 years to get matric. If you can't, we are going to recall you. That's how serious we are in ensuring that people that we deploy to serve our community are people that are going to be useful to our community. We don't want celebrities who are going to move to suburbs after they've been elected.
And Mr. Khoza, how is your party planning now to attract white and Indian voters who may agree with some of the party's plans, but who may feel that maybe it's too radical or that it alienates certain races?
We don't alienate anyone. We are a party for all, but we are not going to go around begging people to love us. It's either you love us or you leave us, no problem. Yes, we are radical. Yes, we are militant. Yes, we want our land. They've been sitting in our land and enriching themselves for too long, excluding our people. So we want to make sure that our people are also allowed to eat on the same table. They've got nothing to fear about the EFF. EFF just wants justice. Why must it be us, black people, who are responsible for peace and begging others when they are not responsible to show remorse and begin to want to share their resources with us?
And lastly, Mr. Khoza, what else will the EFF do differently from the ruling party?
When it comes to employment, we are going to employ people because they are qualified, not because they are our friends and our members. What we have seen happening with the ruling party, we have seen the degeneration of service delivery purely because they employ their friends and relatives, even if their friends and relatives are not qualified to do the job. People who are going to employ, we are going to employ because they've got skills. What they then do, they bring their friends who know nothing about the job. And then once their friends are inside, they then employ consultants at 4 or 5 times the amount so that the consultant will do the job. When you are sitting there, you deploy, you know nothing. The consultant does the job. You come here and you present this beautiful plan that you can't implement because they were done by some consultant sitting somewhere in some boardroom when you are supposed to be working. We are going to make sure that the people that were wrongfully employed because they are connected to certain politicians, we expel them, we ask them to excuse us. We employ people through qualification. Our municipalities have got a lot of chief, but nobody on the ground. So in other words, you've got a lot of directors, executive directors, senior managers. Everybody is senior this, senior that, senior that. And the majority of the money goes to pay these useless people. Trim it at the top, expel the majority of the people that are earning a lot of money doing nothing on the top, do away with the consultants, take that money, put it on the ground so that more people will be on the ground level, fixing potholes, fixing water leaks, building new infrastructure, building new roads. Then once you change the model and the management style of this municipality, it will release money. That's how we're going to do this.
There was KZN Provincial Chairperson for the EFF, Vusi Khoza, in conversation with Polity about the EFF's manifesto.